Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Might and Magic Era of Chaos on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Might and Magic Era of Chaos and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Might and Magic Era of Chaos. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our main web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to the current URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type it, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed at this point on our site of Usitility, at which we find here a in-depth explanation on how to download Might and Magic Era of Chaos on PC. We scroll lower a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Might and Magic Era of Chaos on PC. As you can see here, we access some pros of preferring using this emulator. Now we are ready to proceed to download the Might and Magic Era of Chaos by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on this button, and the download starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do now is to launch the executable file, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to see the installation software considerably better. The installer is very simple. It consists of a couple of possibilities: install and setup path. I will clarify what setup path really does. We simply click on it. And now we realize that we have here the path where in fact the emulator can be set up. If we desire to change this directory, we must click on the Browse option, and now we opt for another folder and install the emulator where we desire. I am going to keep it by default. Then, I click on Back. So I just click Install. Voila! The setup starts and it is going to progress in the download of these megabytes that are shown on the computer screen. After you download it, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your type of access to the web and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they are going super fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator happens to be launched successfully. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will move forward to the right, and once it gets to the end, the emulator will be launched for the first time. The truth is the emulator has been launched, there for the very first time. Before we carry on, as you will notice, it has created a couple of app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is the one we are concerned with. When we need to start Might and Magic Era of Chaos on our PC, we double-click on this specific icon and run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we conduct the next step, which is actually a must-have, and this is to enter the Google Play Store. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is started. Here we are required to log on. At this point, once we are on this page, we must absolutely execute the next step, which is mandatory. So we just click on Sign In. At this moment it shows Checking Info. It can once in a while get stopped at Checking Info, that's why it doesn't move ahead. If that's the case, you may try to connect to your account after a number of hours, it's going to most certainly be repaired. At this moment we can enter our email and password. The email address has to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For example, you can utilize the exact same email you're using at this time in your YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to type my data and I will go back when I have accomplished it. That's it, info entered. Discover Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We will accept them by pressing, I agree. Following, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it'll create a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. Google Play Store is started by default and completely on its own. To set up the application, we have to go to the emulator desktop by clicking this app icon designated green colored. Right now that we are discovering the desktop of the emulator for Android, we can see that we find here the install game button. We just click on the button. There we come with the game. Let's mouse click now on the install option that I'm highlighting now in green. And this will launch the installation. Straight away it is going to download and install the game. It may take a while or it might well be extremely fast. It again all is dependent upon on the internet connection. It's already completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this option I'm emphasizing in green, to be able to launch Might and Magic Era of Chaos for the first time. We're currently on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're on the way to just click this new Might and Magic Era of Chaos icon that has been created. This game app is launched for the first time. Here we end up with it. I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should discuss the volume of that emulator. This is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is actually the first one. We then click on that app icon that I am actually pointing out in green. And the monitor is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the event that we need to enjoy the application using all the screen, we mouse click on this icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen mode. To leave the full screen mode, press the F11 key. Then we would certainly already play in standard display screen mode. At present, I am on the way to show you the computer keys mapping and that is certainly extremely appealing. This way we will be in a position to utilize the game application far more easily. The first point is to click on this application icon. And here you will have the ability to make the recommended setups. I'll go ahead and keep the default configuration, but if you want to adjust that, you may very well do so with no problem. As you can see, the emulator is fully in our language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese. And therefore to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. Then there within many other configuration settings, we just click the language drop down. We can also decide on the language we want, English, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, along with the game. Next time we launch it, would of course be in the opted for language. At this point, you can find another detail that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Gmail saying that a new device has been associated with our own Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Absolutely, we shouldn't worry, considering the fact that emulator is simulating an Google Android tablet or smartphone. In order to determine which device is currently being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. And so we browse here to the model option. And now we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for the video user demo. I hope that you appreciated it, particularly that you found it useful. If so, allow it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have comments, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams ever so often. You get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click on any of the training videos that are showing up on the computer screen and see you in the next instructional videos. Bye.